Please. Today I'm going to do something with you. I'm going to be applying my makeup as well as your makeup. This isn't really a get ready with me video because this is a weekend day. I don't have to go to work. But sometimes it's just nice to play with makeup and make yourself all gussied up and have fun with it. So what I'm going to do is just start with foundation and get you all nice and pampered up so you can look pretty, pretty. Not that you're not gorgeous as it is, but sometimes change can be a bit fun. And I do apologize about my neighbor that's about 6 or 7 houses down there target practicing or something, and it's that's the popping that you might hear. I have been going through a little bit of a makeup obsession phase lately. I discovered a website that has a whole bunch of makeup, and I'm a cheap girl, so I don't spend that much on makeup. I don't get like Ulta or Sephora or anything like that. I get AOA, which is like a dollar store. Everything is a dollar. It's fantastic. Everything is super, super inexpensive. So I got way, way more makeup than I'll probably ever use in my entire life. So let's experiment with it. It's actually really, really nice. I've never really had expensive high-end makeup, so I don't really know what I'm missing, if I'm missing anything at all, but I've been having a lot of fun with makeup lately. The first part, I don't know how to apply makeup either. So the first part that I'm going to do is apply some primer on both of our faces. And this is supposed to be a blur primer. And it has little itty bitty specks of glitter in it, so it's really nice, but it's just a silicone base that's supposed to fill in your pores and blur them and make them look a lot smaller. But that sparkle is probably going to be really nice too. I've been watching a lot of YouTube tutorials about how to apply makeup and what steps go first, and I don't know what I'm doing, but it's fun. I've never used primer before. When I told my husband I'm putting primer on my face, he thought, Are you like putting on car paint or aerosol or you didn't know what we were doing? Okay, I'm gonna put primer on your face. Nice and glittery. And this was something that has kind of been requested in a couple of different videos. People have commented that they wanted a makeup tutorial. Not that I'm good at it really, but it's fun. It's relaxing. After the primer, this is like the prep phase, I'm going to apply some lip scrub. And this is like a sugar scrub. This is the only product that I did not get from that company, AOA. It's from the website shop, missa.com. This is my e.l.f. lip scrub, and I use this a lot. And the nice thing about all the AOA products, if it's important to you, is that they're all vegan and ethically produced. Same with Elf. So I'm just going to put a little bit on my fingertip here. You want to let that kind of scrub a little bit. I'm going to do the same. Just let that sit for a little while. Decided what brush I like the best. I've used these little teardrop sponges, and this is the Wonder Blender. I've never actually had a beauty blender, but a lot of people really, really like this and they compare it to it. The beauty blender is, I think, $20. This was $1.55. I think I'll go with the $1.55 version of it, even if it's not quite the same. And then I also got a couple of brushes that look like this, and I think I like this one the best. It applies the foundation really, really nicely, not to mention that it's super, super, super soft. Although it's got a kitty fur in it. Started with the foundation. Again, when I mention these things, my husband's like, are you going into construction work or something? Applying foundation and primer and... I guess it could be confusing. And for base, I'm going to use BB cream. I've used CC cream before, but this is sort of a medium coverage. I found that it works pretty well throughout the day. I don't have to patch or anything. We're gonna go full on heavy today. I'm gonna get a little bit more glam up. To yours right after mine. Maybe let the primer sit a little bit longer. Maybe I'll start with this. I forgot to get a bobby pin so I could pin my hair back. I might get just a little bit in my hair. This smells nice. last recording, this was kind of how I did my makeup that day. Your turn. I'm not sure if this is quite your skin tone, but we'll see how we can do with it. Brush a little bit. I really like the brush. I think I like the brush most on the nose because I have big pores on my nose and it really helps to kind of hide that. It's not like a full coverage makeup where it's hiding every blemish, but I can also tell you wearing really full coverage makeup makes it very difficult to stay that way. At least for me, when my skin starts to get a little more oily, and you can really see that it's cakey. This helps. Okay. So let me get those areas around your nose here real quick. Do two other little perfecting techniques. This is something I also don't do on a regular basis, but a concealer. I have a little bit of an acne breakout going on, so I'm gonna try to hide those a little bit better. And I love these little, this was a dollar. I can't believe. The concealer. It's really thick, so I'm going to do one eye at a time. And also that little pimple right there. Maybe the blender is better for this. I'm not sure if that hurts it any better. It's better. I'm gonna leave that. I'm gonna do the same to you, okay? This time. I'm gonna use the blender. One side at a time. Also kind of highlights as well. It's really thick and it dries relatively quickly. Is gonna turn out. But let's give it a whirl. I don't even know how to use this. It has a different texture than the concealer. It's not as sticky. Once I know how this works, I'll use it on you. It has more of like a silken feel to it. It's more water-based. Okay. Close your eyes for just a second. Experimenting with all this makeup, it really makes me appreciate all the work and talent that has to go into being able to do makeup. They have so many different techniques and methods for applying stuff and so many different products. I mean, primers and foundations and more primers and baking and all sorts of terminology. That's really... That takes a lot of time. Takes a lot of time. Speaking of baking, I'm going to take a setting powder, and this is just a translucent powder. It doesn't really have any color to it, but it will help to set, at least I think that's what it's supposed to do, to keep everything from moving. Just seen other people do it. But it will look much paler at first. Ooh, I think I got a little too much. I don't intend on staying this way, though. This is what they call baking. So we're just gonna let that sit for a little while, and I'm gonna do the same to you. Always get really, really oily, and I think that this really can help with those areas. But you're gonna look really pale for just a moment. But we'll go, we'll dust it off in a little bit. Helps prevent creasing and all that good stuff. super long process of making ourselves up. I'm going to apply a little bit of powder. This is colored powder. Oh gosh, I look so pale. Next, because I always mess them up, and kind of at this stage, you still have a little bit of an opportunity to fix it if you mess up too badly. So, I'm going to use this. This was the same palette I used in a previous video that people seem to like, the metallic palette. I used all four colors on it, but I think I'm only going to use three today. Deep umber color and do the top of the lid a little bit. Fallout, and that's what I always have problems with. What I really like is that nice purple. I don't know if I'm doing it right. Close your eyelid a little bit for me. Let's start with your left side. Just try to pack that on and get a nice nice soft color. I really like it. Go to your other eye. Close your eyes just a little bit for me. Okay, thank you. On the edges here, so close your eye for me. Just add a little bit of that nice brown. That looks so pretty. And the crease. Finish up my eye here while I still have that color, okay? Oh, wait, I didn't get the other one on. Okay, now let's finish up your eyes. Let's go after the nice purple. And then the crease. I want this to be more of like a nice warm purple. At least I so pretty. It's like a lavender color. I don't know if it really complements any of my features, but I just like purple. Let's get some of that fallout. Baking, is that it? Makes it a little easier to dust that off. Alright, how about some nice contouring? This is something I also don't do very often because I'm not good at it. But a couple of different things. We're gonna try to make the cheekbones look a little more slender. This also has a highlighter in it, but I think I'm gonna save that for another one. That's really pretty. Can you make the duck face for me? Or the fish face, or whatever. Just try to find those lines. It blends out really nicely now. Maybe that's pretty extreme. Pigmentation again. I like it. It looks good. Let us move on to the blush. Highlighter, but it's also a blush, so it's nice because it gives you that nice little rosy pink, but it also gives you that little sparkle. So nice glitzy. Transformation has begun. See how much time this takes? Oh man. I could never do this on a daily basis. It takes so much time to do. And now we're going to use an actual highlighter. And I'm going to also put this on the very top of the eyelid, by the brow bone, just because it's really sparkly. Glimmers. I really, really like those. What's next? I'm not good with fake eyelashes, although I got them, so I think I'm gonna hold off on that. Let us move on to the eyebrows. This is a really cool, like a wax pencil, and it has a little spoolie on the one side, which is really good for combing the eyebrows and giving them a little bit of shape. And then on the other side, you have your waxy color, which is a kind of a medium brown sort. So comb my eyebrows up a little bit. Fill them in a little. And I do this every single day. I'm definitely an eyebrow makeup kind of gal. have scissors around here somewhere. I have little unruly hairs. I'm just going to... There we go. The spoolie because it also kind of blends out the color a little bit better. So it doesn't look like such a hard line. So, your turn. Brush it out, make it a little more subtle. This is not the liner. Alright, well, I just saved ourselves from that disaster, trust me. So we'll move on to the mascara. And this is Big Fat Lash. This is probably the best mascara I have ever used. And I've had Avon and Mary Kay that were gifted to me. Go ahead and open your eyes really wide, but look down. And the bristles are really stiff, which make it really, really nice to like comb through your lashes. Me so much better. Well, maybe not necessarily better, but so much more pronounced than my natural lashes. Looks the same on you. I'm trying to get those little guys on the end stuff though. Thank you. an obsession over lipstick lately. I have gotten so many lipsticks lately. I've really started to have a problem, especially with like the liquid lipsticks. Then the lip gloss. I really like this. I got three more of them coming. So I'm developing a makeup obsession. I've never been much of a girly girl, so I'm exercising that muscle thoroughly. And then just some kind of nude-ish lipsticks. My absolute favorite is called Naughty. And this is probably the nicest red lipstick I've ever had. I don't usually wear dark colors. I usually go with kind of a more natural, subtle look, but today we're gonna go Naughty. And Naughty is gonna be very, very nice. So I'll show you what I mean in just a minute. They're metallic, but this can wear it all day, and it just looks, I don't know, I really like it. So, I'm not sure if you want to do the dark, or if you want to do any of the other colors. Let's do it. Okay. Just want you to open up your mouth and go. I'm gonna rest my pinky on your chin here just to kind of stable my hand, okay? It's funny, I never realized that my lips are very not symmetrical until I started trying to follow the line very precisely. And consistent. Very nice. You look fantabulous. And you are all done up for the day. Me too. Puff up my hair a little bit. Puff up your hair a little bit. You are ready to hit the town, my lady, my man. Be whatever you want to be today. I am going to set this with some setting spray so that it will stay as long as possible. This is something I also never use. I think I might just go sit in front of a fan and wait for my face to dry now. I won't subject you to that same torture. But you look So go and enjoy your day. I hope that you had as much fun as I did, and you look great.